activity for kids, like running to, you know, running to the streets. I mean, it's a setup, basically.
You know it's a setup.
That's crazy. I didn't think about it like that.
Setup. Government setup.
I was mad. I'm walking in New York, like every single block. I'm like just taking pictures. Like I wish Trenton had this. Like every block is a court.
State this is. This is New Jersey. So it's not like that.
Then you got rich towns. You got Princeton. You got Lawrence. You got all these towns. Oh,
we the capital, bro.
That's crazy.
Trenton is the capital of New Jersey.
That's crazy.
We don't got nothing. No courts. Can't
get. I got Rider and Prince University, all in one area.
Nothing.
Y'all can't get nada.
But that's why the YMCA that you got to get
you gotta pay. Like, who got $5 every day to go play basketball?
That's why I gotta get a petition. Write a petition up and say what's needed. And say what it'll help stop. And then you get everybody to sign it. And once everybody starts signing, everybody starts, you know, getting involved. And having like a little meet. Instead of like stuff hitting the fan and then trying to go do something, you should just do it before it hit the fan. And say, you know what? I'm gonna make this happen. And, you know what I'm saying, get a group of people and fight for what you want. Because at the end of the day, like, kids saying you just chilling, this is doing something. Like, he's at least playing basketball. You know what I mean? That's sad. Riding a bike all day. This bike life, huh? Everything is bike life. That's crazy. That's why in my head, like, the
park,
everything is bike life. Because in my head, where I'm doing the playground, where I'm doing the basketball at my playground, we don't, like, that playground ain't had no mural, and the courts was messed up. Fixed all that. Got a mural.
He be having them picking up trash and everything. Like,
yeah, too, because like when you respect the community, you gotta give you like some type of leeway. Say what you get what you want and ask what you want. You know what I'm saying? Because like if y'all ain't gonna ask for it, they gonna give it to somebody else. Because that money gonna go somewhere. You know what I'm saying? Every year they give out some type of money that can actually be towards something that can. You know what I mean? But I don't know what to say. Like just fight for whatever you want. That's why I'm setting this message on tomorrow. All these kids, I gotta say what y'all want. Put your hands up, don't shoot us. Cause that's what happened. Running around here acting crazy. Cops come. That's the first thing you wanna do.
That shirt will be crazy though. Put that on the shirt.
Don't shoot. I'm telling you, like, it's sad though, but my thing is though, like, we gotta be smarter like as a whole, you know what I'm saying? Black people, you can't try to fight everybody that you see. Or try to shoot everybody you see. That's what they want us to do, you know what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, like, it's our choice. We're making the wrong decisions, even when we don't have no outlets. Like how you said, you the first kid I ever heard saying, let's get a petition. That's crazy. You need to put that to use. Put it to use. Write what you want. I mean, at the end of the day, like, what they want to say, no? They ain't going to know unless you try. And when you don't try, you don't know. So I just say, why not write a petition and try to get people to sign? You gonna have her help you out. You got this guy helping you out. You got neighbors. For sure, an old lady is signing it. And if you get an old lady signing it, it's over. She pay taxes. Get them taxpayers to sign it. Take it up to the cabin. Drop it off at the door.
Just
drop it off. Like, ain't right. They know what's going on. They want people to recycle and shit like that, but when it comes to some basketball, they be like, oh, no, nah, they ain't got.
That's what I was trying to, I'm like, how do you get these free basketballs? Because like, I was in the other projects, and the kid was like, I want to play, but I don't got a ball. And I'm like, damn, I don't need that. I'm like, I would try to ball.
Where that kid at?
He in the other projects.
I got a ball.
Yeah, you got 1,000 balls, nigga.
You should throw me one too.
That boy. This ain't for sick.
That's crazy shit.
I felt super bad. I was like, damn. Like, yeah, we wanna play, but I don't got a basketball.
That's sick.
So I'm like, how am I supposed to get a basketball?
Like, all the basketballs I got, I'm giving them away tomorrow.
I know, I see that.
Keep them going. I may keep like 10 of them now.
I mean, put me one to the...
Yeah, I keep 12 and give out 38 of them. I mean, like, shit, like...
That's what we're talking about. Like, you gotta get...
Because the kid even have it.
But the thing is, you got some kids, how they gonna get to Philly? Like, I posted it on my Facebook and his parents was like, I want my sons to go, but they, like, I can't take them.
Right,
like,
it's sad, but you know what I'm saying? That's why we wanna make it here. Have it here.
They play ball whenever they can, when I'm around. Like, they play ball though, but they not. It's different from right out here. Like out here, like you can play some ball, but down there it's like straight up. If you ain't on the block and you ain't playing no ball, like you just what you doing? Like you just out there living in the way. So them young boys, like they gravitate to whoever is like what's in. So like if the streets is in, they gonna be on the streets. If the ball is in, they gonna be on the ball. They not consistent enough. So like they need a little bit of like motivation. That's why like I try to stay around as much as possible because it's like hard, man.
That's why I try to keep it.
Because I mean, like anything you think about, like a young kid like a goof, it's always because somebody is showing them how to do it. Like it's never because they got a right mind to do it. Some of them they got their own little personal mindsets, but some of them they just follow whatever was in the trend. You know what I'm saying? Like you see the clothes people wear, like whatever's in, they gonna wear it. Like it's people scared to be different out here. You know what I'm saying? But that's what I thought about being different.
What you doing tomorrow?
I gotta go get my football gear at 10.
Like around 1:30, 2. You try to go to Heritage Day, right?
Our special guest today is a Trenton native and former standout basketball player at Trenton Catholic Academy and the University of South Carolina. She's a documentarian and an entrepreneur. She founded Fan Favorite, an apparel and lifestyle that promotes hard work and a positive mindset. She is Lakeisha Sutton. Lakeisha, it is a pleasure and an honor to have you in today.
Nice to be here, Kevin. Thank you for having me.
So, you know, I got an opportunity of a documentary just came out. It's called From the Projects of Fan Favorite, the Lakeisha Sutton story. And I had an opportunity over the weekend to sit down and watch it. And, you know, I said this to you in a message on Facebook the other day. I was inspired after watching it. I really enjoyed it. It's about an hour and 20 minutes long. It's split into 9 parts. You can find it on YouTube by looking up your channel, Lakeisha Sutton. And you've also have links to it on your Twitter and Facebook, Twitter, Fan Favorite, Instagram, Fan Favorite 11, excuse me, for both of those. And, you know, I think the thing that stuck out with me most is how raw it was, how you pull back the curtain on your life. And that's not an easy thing to do for 99.9% of people.
Yes. I just felt like it was time to tell my story because a lot of people follow me on social media. They ask different questions and I try to answer them, but I couldn't answer them the way I wanted to. So I just wanted to be very honest and genuine and let people know where I come from, Trenton, New Jersey, things that I've been through, things that I'm going through now to hopefully help somebody else because we all have a story to tell. So I'm just using mine to encourage other people to share theirs.
And I beat you to 7.
It drove me to know that there's no reason to give up. Anything can happen as long as you want it to happen and you put anything into it that you feel like is worth it. Worth it. Worth it. Worth it.
Yo, what up, Instagram fam? I just want to thank everybody who brought a shirt, brought more shirts, tweeted about it, Instagrammed about it. like the pictures. I see it all. Thank you so much. I'm so grateful. Trent.
I gotta take care of my people. I gotta return the favor to my moms. That's where the pressure at right there. Like, that's real life. You dig? This shit right here, they provide me a way to take care of my family. It's way bigger than me. Like, God put a nigga here for a reason. It just never been about me to myself, because I know, you know what I'm saying? I'm trying to help some niggas. I'm trying to, like, do something big. And so I do it for them and for my family to make sure we straight. You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?